Atrophic rhinitis. Atrophic rhinitis is a chronic inflammation of the nose characterized by atrophy of nasal mucosa and turbinate bones. The nasal cavity are roomy and full of foul-smelling crust. Atrophic rhinitis is of two types, primary and secondary. Primary atrophic rhinitis, etiology. Mnemonic is given here, hernia. Hereditary factors, H for hereditary factor, E for endocrinal disturbances, R for racial factors, N for nutritional deficiency, I for infections, and A for autoimmune process. Hereditary factor disease is also known to in more than one family member in the same family. Endocrinal factors start at puberty, involve females. Endocrinal disorders, racial factors, they are more common in white and yellow races and are more susceptible than natives of equatorial Africa. Nutritional deficiency of vitamin A and D cause atrophic rhinitis, and iron is also the cause of atrophic rhinitis. Infective, various organisms like Klebsiella, Staphylococci and Streptococci are the cause of atrophic rhinitis. Autoimmune processes are also the cause of atrophic rhinitis. Pathology. Ciliated columnar cell is lost and is replaced by stratified squamous cells. Disease may be seized after menopause. Atrophy of seromucinous gland, venous blood sinusoids and nerve elements. Arteries in the mucosa, periosteum and the bone show obliterative and arthritis. The bone of turbinate undergo sinuses are small due to arrested development. Clinical features of atrophic rhinitis are marked anosmia, merciful anosmia, foul smell from the nose, making the person feel very uncomfortable in the society. Nasal obstruction with the crust, epistaxis. When you remove the crust, epistaxis is seen. Nasal cavity to be full of greenish, grey, blackish, dry crust covering the turbinates. Atrophy of the turbinates are seen. Roomy cavity is seen. Posterior wall of the nasal cavity can be seen easily because of atrophy of turbinate bones. You can clearly see the posterior wall of the nasal cavity. Nasal mucosa appear pale. Septal perforation and dermatitis of the nasal vestibule may be present. Nose shows some subtle deformity. Subtle deformity are also seen in case of leprosy and other diseases too. So don't get confused. Atrophic changes may also be seen in the pharyngeal mucosa. Atrophic changes are also seen in larynx too. And hoarseness of voice is present when the mucosa of larynx get affected. Hearing impairment may be noticed because of obstruction to eustachian tube. Paranasal sinuses are very small and underdeveloped. On X-ray, you can see opacity at that area. Prognosis: the disease persists for years, but there is a tendency to recover spontaneously in middle ear. Treatment: medical treatment. Complete cure of the disease is not yet possible, but treatment aim at maintaining nasal hygiene by removing the crust and associated putrefied smell and to further check crust formation. Nasal irrigation is done with the help of soda bicarbonate, soda biborate, sodium chloride 2 parts in 280 ml of water is used to irrigate the nasal cavity. And other treatment is 25% of glucose and glycerin is used, and another one is estradiol spray is used. Systematic use of streptomycin and potassium iodide liquefies the nasal secretion. Surgically, you can you can do Young's operation. In this, nostrils are closed and opened after 6 months or later. Mucosa may convert to normal and crusting reduce. Nowadays, modified Young operation are performed. Modified Young operation, they partially close the nostril, not fully, but some partially. Another one is narrowing of the nasal cavities is done so that the crusting is reduced and the mucosa may revert back to normal. Narrowing of the nasal cavities. Some mucosa injection of Teflon paste. This will increase the weight and this is very useful.